Hello friends, this is Ashwin. In this video, I will look at the game played between Magnus Carlsen versus the world. The match was sponsored by G-Star and was powered by the chess.com. In this game, Magnus had a white pieces and Grandmaster Hikaru Nakamura, MVL and Judit Polgar were had suggested the moves for the world team. In this game, Magnus started the game with pawn to d4, now knight to f6 by the world team. Pawn to c4, pawn to g6, and we might have either Grunfeld defense or the King's Indian on the board. Knight to f3, bishop to g7, and now pawn to g3. Black castle here, Magnus played bishop to g2, and now pawn to d6, and finally a King's Indian structure on the board. Magnus played knight to c3, and now knight to c6. This position Magnus castled, and here comes pawn on e5. And here Magnus played pawn to d5, gained the space. And after knight e7, pawn to e4 was played. And here black decided to attack in the center with pawn to c6. Or you can say try to break the center with pawn to c6, not the attack. Pawn to a4 was played and try to gain the space on the queen side. Bishop to g4 was played, pinning the knight, and now pawn to a5. In this position, black committed a move that is c capture on d5, and after c capture on d5, it was obvious that c file is open, and number 2, white has some space on the a file for his rooks, and bit space on the queen side too, so opening up the file on the queen side will actually help Magnus. In the game, queen to d7 was played, try to exchange on h3. But bishop to e3 was played, and after rook f to c8, it is clear that play will be on queen side, where Magnus is having space. Queen to a4 was played, typical of Magnus. Knight to e8. In this case, if black try to exchange the pieces with queen takes on a4, then rook capture on a4, and after bishop to d7, Magnus would be having a great pressure against this b7. So instead, after queen to a4, black decided to play knight to e8, and now asking Magnus to trade up the queens, where rook to a4 won't be possible. So knight to d4 was played, knight is aiming to c4, from which actually she can generate some pressure on this pawn on d6, queen to d8, and now queen to b4 attacking the b7 pawn, and now knight to c7 was played. And of course here you can't take the pawn, otherwise simply rook to c8 and queen is trapped. But anyways, after knight to c7, we have knight to c4, knight to a6 attacking the queen, and now Magnus captured the b7 pawn. And after rook capture on c4, queen capture on a6, black played rook to b4 and attack this b2 pawn. So here Magnus first played pawn to f3, so that queen can be played on e2, and this f3 moves gains a tempo. And although this bishop on g2 has no good prospect over this h1a diagonal, so bishop is going to on g3. Therefore pawn on f3 is justified. Bishop to c8 was played, and now queen to e2, defending this b2 pawn. Pawn to f5 was played, and now queen to d2. So in case of f4, white can simply take on f4. Bishop to a6 was played, attacking the rook, and now rook f to c1, and queen to b8 was played, attacking the b2 once more. And here a good move would be to play knight to d1, but Magnus played for some tricks. He played knight to a4. Idea is to play knight to b4, and this attacks the rook, and if pawn capture, then simply queen capture on b4. So basically try to win the exchange. Rook to b3 was played, rook to c3, and now rook b4 was played. Black decided not to exchange the rooks, and now rook c to a3. And again, same trick is there, knight to b6, and here f4 was played. I think better would to take just pawn on f4, and after pawn capture, bishop capture, white is having really nice position, two extra pawn. But after f4, Magnus played this bishop to f2. And bishop to h6, f4 pawn, and here knight to b6 was played. In fact, there was no need to complicate the game. White can simply play pawn to g4 and keep his advantage. But knight to b6 is a bit complicated. Here, Magnus wins the rook, but at the cost of two pieces. In the game, f capture on g3 was played. This bishop attacks the queen. So queen takes on b4, and after pawn takes on f2 check, king takes on f2. Magnus won the rook at the cost of knight and the bishop, because this knight on b6 is pinned and is lost. Of course, here pawn takes on b6 is not that good because of a capture on b6, and after bishop b7, white can exchange one pair of rooks with rook capture on a8, and after bishop capture on a8, bishop to h3, bishop to b7, and now queen to a4. And friends, in this position, this knight has a no good prospect. So of course, this is a good position, and in fact winning position for white. This queen is going to be on a7, and this is winning. So in the game, king capture f2, bishop to c8 was played. Black realized that this knight is pinned, so there is no need to keep this bishop on the a-file, on the a6, and so that white cannot force the rook exchanges, one pair of rook. So after bishop c8, rook to b3 was played, and of course now this queen is having support, so black is forced to take this knight. So pawn capture, queen capture on b6, and now Magnus is having rook and two pawns, sorry, rook and one pawn against a knight and bishop. So in this position, queen to a7 was played, and after pawn to a6, of course bishop capture a6 is not possible because of queen takes on a7, rook takes on a7, and now rook to b6 wins. So after a6, king to f7 was played, queen capture queen, rook takes queen on a7, and now rook to b6 attacking this d6, and there is no way to defend this d6. In the game, king e8 was played. Of course, here rook to d7 is not good move, otherwise simply pawn to a7 wins. So king to e8 was played, and now rook capture on d6. So now Magnus is having rook plus two pawns against the knight and the bishop. In the game, bishop to f8 was played, and now rook to b6, and here comes knight capture on d5, a trick. But it is not necessary for white to capture this knight, otherwise simply bishop to c5, and black is winning even. So knight capture d5, and Magnus played rook to b8, pinning this bishop, and also there is an attack on the knight. So I think black is losing a piece here. Knight to e7 can be played, but then comes bishop to h3, again attacking this bishop once more, and after rook to c7, pawn to a7 is winning, and after king to d8, rook to c1 is winning. So bishop to c5 actually was played. After rook to b8, bishop c5 check was played, and after king to g3, now knight to e7, but it doesn't make any change because bishop h3, and now king to d8, bishop capture on c8, knight capture on c8, and now rook to c1 was played. And in fact, this bishop or the knight is lost. In the game, rook to c7 was played. Of course, if you play king to c7, and then simply rook to b5 wins automatically. So rook c1, and now rook c7 was played. And here comes a rook capture c5, a last trick. A rook capture c5, and now pawn to a7, and black has to give up his rook for this pawn, and so white would be having a pawn and the rook for the knight, so this is simply winning. So in this position, actually the world team resigned. So friends, how was the video? I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please do subscribe my channel for more videos. Thanks for watching. Your comments and questions, please. Bye bye.